was acute, who lived in digs and played the flute. A flautist on a nun could stem, she practiced hard till 2 a.m.
In 2015, I had recently taken part in the Park Lane Group Young Artist Series, and Park Lane Group actually approached me again to do another concert in their Purcell Room series. We were going to do some concerts of Joe Horovitz's music, with Joe Horovitz being on the stage with us in conversation. And I'd been working a lot with Matthew, who I knew also was a recent Park Lane Group artist, and I thought it'd be a nice opportunity to bring him back in and do some of Joe's music together.
And afterwards, I really thought it would be good to get this music recorded, to expose it to a wider audience. But in fact, there wasn't enough for a complete disc. So we put the ball in Joseph's court and asked him who he felt would make the best partnership. Well, Joseph suggested Jeffrey Bush, so we set about trying to weigh up exactly what else there was.
And actually, we found that there was a huge amount of repertoire out there, and in fact, basically most of it had been unrecorded, so we thought, what an exciting opportunity to put it out there to a wider audience.
But they shall not so, but they shall not so, none but I, none but I, none but I, this lip must own.
One standalone gem of a piece is Love for Such a Cherry Lip, which is very humorous and very playful and very cheeky, and we particularly love that song, especially as it seems to reflect Joe's cheeky humour a lot of the time too.
Well, Love for Such a Cherry Lip is the main point of intersection between the two composers in terms of tone and humour and musical language. And pithiness and wit is a real theme in Jeffrey's music, such as Archie at the Zoo. But there's also a more mysterious side, and in musical terms, a more ethereal sound, which he gets to, such as in Mirabile Mysterium, which is a multi-movement song cycle. And it's very unusual insofar as it has texts in different languages. It has Latin, it has Middle English. And also, Jeffrey's adapted the text from various sources to suit the music.
A marvellous thing have I mused in my mind, how that very dust sprang right out of the ground, and Eustitia for all mankind.
Complementing Mirabile Mysterium by Jeffrey Bush, we have another large-scale work by Joe Horovitz, Lady Macbeth. It's a very dramatic work, it's hugely powerful, and it is a narrative of three soliloquies of Lady Macbeth's sewn together to form one piece.
Out! Damned spot! Out, I say! One, two, why then 'tis time.
This is the piece where the piano and singer really work together in a dramatic, theatrical sense.
Fie, my lord, fie! A soldier and a field, what need we fear? Who knows it, when none can call a power to.
A really special piece is Zum 11. März by Joe, and it's a particularly important part of his history, really, because he came over to England as part of the Anschluss in 1938, and this piece, which has a German text, unlike all of his other work, which is in English, pays tribute to a very great poet, Theodor Körner.
Joseph's a very, very versatile composer, and on the one hand, you've got that very emotional piece and luscious-sounding piece with words by Körner. And then on the other hand, the very classical sounding, classic kind of humour with the text by Michael Flanders, which is foie gras.
The maitre d'hôtel has the eye of an eagle. Maladroit.
Another delight for us was to record Romance by Joe Horovitz, because it was actually arranged specifically for us. It's a very charming, witty and amusing little piece, and it's got an exciting duality in the fact that we are also musicians as well.
Each night would sup, the bass came down, or the flute went up, with a from the flute and a from the bass. The neighbours cried, it's a disgrace.
What we got a chance to do is to really get to know the music inside out, having got to know it in advance, and to rehearse it and to perform it, and then to really immerse ourselves in it.
The flute was the bride, the bass the groom. Where they abide, there's a diddly boom boom. The once in a while the neighbours fret, they can but smile at the soft duet.
We've really enjoyed getting to know this music, and we're looking forward to bringing it to a wider audience.